Hi guys, Alec Pierce, Vintage Scuba. Yep, I got some old stuff for you again, some old stuff that you won't see anywhere else. Very unlikely. You certainly won't see it anywhere else with such a great commentary as I can give. Anyway, listen, as I found this thing, I'm rooting around in my boxes and I come across this old thing and I laughed like heck about it. I don't think this was around for very long. It really was kind of silly, but this type of device was not uncommon, and there is actually something similar to it even today. But the adventure, I'm going to give you about 3 seconds to guess what this is. 1, 2, 3, time's up. Okay, this is a tank carrier. It's a tank carrier, yeah, really not for carrying your tank. Now, most have just grabbed the valve and so on, but you know, marketing people, what they are, they want to, I can do better, I can make $1 million by selling it, so they make a tank carrier. Today we have nylon tank carriers, tank totes are called, you'll walk off with the tank. And some divers today, if you just get it fairly large, I think it's about 2.5 inch solid stainless or brass ring. Take the valve out, put the valve back in. When you grab that ring with a hook for side mounts, or for carrying, it's the same type of thing. But this is a tank carrier. This is from the 60s, roughly. And you would take the valve out. This would fit, this was designed to fit over the stem, the part of the tank that comes up, when it comes up and curves in, there's a stem that the valve goes in. This fit over the stem. And there's a nut there, and you put, and so it's just tight on the stem of the tank. Then you could reach down with a couple of fingers and pick it up, or you could put something on here, you could hang things on it, you can actually carry the tank with this little handle. That's all it was. And not a big deal, but you've never seen one before. So don't laugh at me, Kevin. You've never seen it before. I thought I'd show it to you. Anyway, okay, we'll look at something a little more serious. This is serious stuff. Whoa, yeah, I'm going to tip this a little bit this way so you can see what's written on the top. Cornelius compressor. Well, that's pretty neat. Yeah, this is Cornelius compressor from the 40s. So why have I got this here? Scuba diving wasn't even around in the 40s. Oh yes, it was. It wasn't very popular. It wasn't very well known. But this isn't from scuba. No, this is from an airplane, from an early airplane. Usually Navy planes used a Cornelius compressor. They use this for various things on the airplane, but the most common use, the most common application, or the reason it was there, was to create compressed air. The compressed air was stored in tanks. We actually used to use some of those old U.S. Air Force, USAF tanks to make scuba tanks, another story. So, and they would store some air in tanks. The tanks were like this, like big watermelons. And so there'd be air stored in there. What was that air for? Well, hydraulic systems in those days were not fantastic. And hydraulic systems, they require power and fluid and tanks and pressure and lines and so on. Air systems are a little simpler. So this particular tank, which runs on 24 volts, if you get a close-up of the tag, you see it's a 24-volt DC. Coincidentally enough, that's what airplanes use. Son of a gun, at least they used to. I'm not sure what they use today. But airplanes run on 24 volts. Yeah, like maybe like two car batteries. And this compressor at the correct time, based on the pressure valve, it would run, and it would fill up those little air tanks on the airplane, ready to move the landing gear up and down. That's right. They used compressed air to raise and to lower the landing gear. So that's what, that's just that simple. It's a little Cornelius compressor made right in the USA. I think it's in New England somewhere. I'm just guessing at that right now. So why am I showing you this for Vintage Cuba? Well, I'm showing you this because there's a gentleman by the name of Ron Dukowski. I think that's correct. Pardon me, Ron, if you're watching. I spoke to Ron not long ago, a few years ago now. He's not a young man either, nor am I, but he's older than me. And he was a very avid scuba diver, and he was a great do-it-yourselfer as well. And Ron actually made several articles. One of his articles was on how to build your own scuba diving lung. No, that's not what it was, because the word scuba hadn't been invented. How to build your own diving lung, using two of those tanks I just described out of a U.S. Air Force war surplus store off a plane, and a U.S. Air Force oxygen diluter. I'm going to show you all this stuff in an upcoming. You could double tanks, two hose regulator, and hoses. Let's go diving. all built from scratch in your garage. That's right. He wrote that article. And I spoke to him about it, and he was quite enthusiastic to talk to me. I have that article as well. It was in an old Popular Mechanics, or was it Science and Mechanics magazine? I'll show you the article, too. However, he wrote another article. Yeah, I told you he was a very avid do-it-yourselfer. He also had an article that was just, build your own diving lung compressor. Build your own diving lung compressor. And it's all in there. And there's a list of parts. You know, you need tools, hammer, screwdriver, and so on. You need pipe. And in the list of parts is, wait for it, Cornelius compressor from the United States Air Force. Surplus, of course. And that's what you would do. So you would go to your local Army, Navy store or war surplus store. These would be very, very common. I don't know if there are any more war surplus stores. I went to a store in Florida a couple of months ago, and it said war surplus on the outside. It wasn't a war surplus store, but in the description it had war surplus. And I ran into the place, and they had some old jackets and some old helmets and stuff like that. Not really a lot of surplus. War surplus stores, the way I remember them, were fantastic. You know, all kinds of this stuff. Bins full of stuff that they got. Okay, I'll give you, and they got all kinds of knives, guns. We used to buy old 303 Lee Enfields and Garands and so on. Sometimes brand new, oily and wrapped in paper and cheap. Oh, yeah, $3 for a really nice K-bar knife that sells for $150 now. And 303 carbines, $19, brand spanking new, still wrapped in paper. And compressors, just like this. So you bought one of these Cornelius compressors, this is it. You bought one of these, okay? And they'd be about, they might be as much as $25 back then. And you had Ron Dalkowski's instructions from the Science and Mechanics magazine, and a little bit handy. You would take one of these, you took off the motor, the 24-volt motor, and you bolted this onto a plate. There's a place to bolt it onto a plate, and you put a pulley on there, and a little electric motor with a pulley beside it. You could plug it, and just went to pump to 1,500. But if you follow Ron's directions, you could get it up to 2,000. Now, the tanks in those days were only 2,150 or 2,250. So you could literally fill your own scuba tank with your own scuba compressor. It wasn't fast. It wasn't fast. It was less than a cubic foot a minute. So it would take you, you know, 3/4 of an hour or an hour, maybe a bit more than that, to fill your scuba tank. But you plug into the wall and fill your scuba tank. It was great. He even had a little filter on there. I'm going to see if I can find that magazine and insert it into this video. So you can see the picture of the finished unit, picture of Ron Dabkowski himself, actually. And there's the scuba compressor, Cornelius scuba compressor, United States Air Force, that you can use to make your own scuba compressor. We did all kinds of this stuff. We made all kinds of things, knives. Fins. Do you believe that there was a magazine that had an article on how to make your own fins? Yeah, they were great. Canvas covered, glued on. No, they were pretty neat. It was a lot of fun back in the old days. We didn't have dive stores like today. You couldn't walk into a dive store and buy a camera housing. You wanted to take pictures underwater, you went and bought some plastic. And you made one. And there were articles about it. It was a lot of fun. It was wonderful in the old days. A lot of fun. A lot different than today. Today is wonderful, too. I still enjoy diving. 70 years, and I'm still enjoying diving. But anyway, I thought I'd show you that. You may not ever see one of these anywhere else. A genuine U.S. Air Force Cornelius compressor that can be made into a scuba compressor. I hope you got a kick out of that. Oh, I thought I'd do one more thing. What do you want to do? Zoom in there, Kevin? Okay, one more thing. Some of you guys have been asking about the junk on my mantle. And so I said I'd point out a couple of things. Let me see if I can find something back here that's interesting. What have I got back here? Well, I've got, I've got this. This is an old beam scale. Let me bring it up front there. This is a genuine old, what's called a beam scale. And it's actually very simple. If you needed to weigh something like this, let's weigh this. So we'll put that on there. Like so. You see what happens? It's not level. So now you would take this weight here, Kevin, and you move that over a little bit until it balances. And then one more notch. Okay, that's balanced again. So that weighs 2 pounds. That's the way it worked. Put it back to zero, you see? And so you could weigh a lot on here. And you could actually weigh heavy things on here as well by adding extra weights to the end. So that's what that is. It's all made of solid brass. I shined it up. I spotted this somewhere and it looked kind of neat. And I thought it looked kind of neat hanging on my mantle. So there's one of the things that somebody's mentioned on there, my old-fashioned brass beam scale. I thought that was kind of neat. I'm a collector. We'll talk about some more stuff. I actually have a Big Bang cannon. Have you ever heard of Big Bang? This is old, but the company is still in business. They're in New York, and these are great. Oh boy, do they bang. Maybe I'll show you that sometime. Anyway, there you go. Cornelius compressor, some other neat stuff. Alec Pierce Vintage Scuba. I gotta go. I'm getting old.